Hi, welcome to Bellevue Lab. My name is Danny. Today we're going to show you how to run and process a urine and a chemistry test in our lab. We're going to take it from it coming down the tube station all the way to racking, and you'll see all the processes in between, how we decant things, etc. These are two specimens that we'll be using today. We have made special fake patients for this, so everything that you'll see here is not real patient demographics, but it is real samples. So this is a tube station. It's hooked up to all the hospital. This is how we send or receive things. Well, we mostly send paperwork up to the clinics or to different floors, but the floors and the clinics send us down most of their samples through this tube station. When a tube comes down, it'll drop over on this side, and it'll just kind of fall in here. Once we see that there's a tube down there, whoever's in SR, specimen processing, will go up and grab it. We've just taken the sample from the tube station. I'm opening up the tube, taking out the specimens and verifying that there isn't anything else hidden underneath this foam protector pad. That's used to just help specimens not jostle around inside the tube. So these will come down double bagged. What I'm gonna do now is just take out all the specimens and verify that it's the same patient for all the specimens. We never wanna have two different patients in the same bag. So we're verifying that all the names and all these stickers here is the same patient. If we have different patients in the same bag, that has to be rejected. That's just for safety purposes, because you never know if there's been a mix-up between patients. So anything that's in the same bag has to be from the same patient, as we see here. I'm gonna take this over now to my specimen processing area, and I'm gonna start off by typing up. So here we see the orders. These orders are gonna should match the orders that are on the labels. For example, we have a CBC, a CMET, which matches what we have here. And we have a UMAC, which also matches what we have there. So now we're gonna log it in using the collection time and date. So we're typing in the collection time as it appears on these tubes. So this was collected at 11:50. Collection date is today. Receive date is today, and the receive time is 12:19. So whoever collected the tubes will write down their collector initials down here. In this instance, since I'm the one that collected these, I'll put in my collector codes. And then there's different work orders. It could be lab, it could be a phlebotomist, a nurse. So once we verify that everything is matched up to the labels, we can hit save. When they come from upstairs, sometimes the labels might look slightly different. So the labels that print off here are the labels that our instruments are actually going to read. For example, labels used by the clinic and our infusion center are what they're called temporary labels that are not able to be read by our instruments. So by doing what we just did, checking in the samples, this transfers all that information into a machine-readable label that then we can stick over the original tube labels. And so what I'm doing now here is gonna rip this off. What I'm gonna do is verify that whatever the system printed still matches what we have on the labels sent down to us. For example, I'm going and matching up the patient name, the MRN, and the order code. So here's a CMET, there's a CMET, same with the urine. Got a UMAC. So I'm putting on the machine readable barcodes on the actual specimens themselves now. You always want to transfer over the collector codes, which in this instance, it was me who collected it earlier. So that's me. And if you are the one that's relabeling a specimen, you also have to put down your initials just so we could track who's relabeling who in case there's ever a clerical issue that we need to go back and double check. Urines have to be further processed. So we're going to decant it, and it's going to print off a decant label. In order to do that, go to Smart, Processing, Decant. Our spot here at Bellevue, I'm not sure if this changes with location, is BDEC. We're going to scan our CID, and we're going to hit Processed. So now the system has printed off a decant, also known as a child label. So this is a parent label. This is a child label. As you can see, again, the patient name, the MRN, the date of birth, all that info should match with the exception of the actual barcode. So this barcode ends in 70. This barcode ends in 71. So the parent label and the child label. This will make sense once we take it further down into the manuals area.